It's AumSum time!
What if French fries disappeared?
Huh? No problem. I will launch tasty AumSum fries.
Oh, AumSum.
To buy this t-shirt, visit AumSum.com.
Firstly, French fries are extremely popular at McDonald's. If French fries disappeared, sales at McDonald's may go down. Secondly, French fries are generally considered to be not good for health. If French fries disappeared, some people may actually lose weight. Thirdly, if French fries disappeared, French people may go on strike. Fourthly, if French fries disappeared, sale of potatoes may see a sharp downturn. Lastly, many people love to eat French fries with ketchup. If French fries disappeared, sale of ketchup may go down. How were French fries invented?
Don't know, dude, but let's give that inventor a dab.
Yes, surely. French fries are loved all across the globe. But who exactly introduced these golden strips to the world? One popular theory traces the origins of French fries to Belgium. It is said that in Belgium, poor villagers living near Meuse River often ate fried fish caught from the river. However, winters caused the river to freeze, forcing the villagers to find alternative sources of food, thus turning towards potatoes. They cut and fried the potatoes in the same way as they used to fry the fish. Then, during World War I, American soldiers stationed at Belgium were given these fried potatoes to eat. They absolutely loved the taste. Since the dominant language of Belgium was French, the soldiers named the fried potatoes as French fries. And voila, French fries were invented. Is spicy food bad for you?
Obviously, because whenever I eat spicy food, my mouth seems to be on fire.
This is because spicy food generally contains chili peppers. Chili peppers have a chemical called capsaicin. When capsaicin comes in contact with our tongue, it activates the heat-sensing receptors instead of our taste buds. As a result, our brain thinks that our mouth is on fire.
So, shall I call the fire brigade?
Oh, just listen. Capsaicin present in spicy food is not necessarily bad for everybody. Only those people who have a low tolerance level or don't have a habit of eating spicy food can experience some problems like burning mouth, irritation of the stomach lining, heartburn, etc.
Why does salt make food taste better?
Wait, I'll explain. Salt, which is basically sodium chloride, makes almost everything taste better. Whether it is French fries, certain fruits, curries, or even cookies, we like at least a little salt in all these foods. According to researchers, we've evolved to like salt maybe because our bodies need salt for survival.
What? Salt for survival?
Indeed. Sodium present in salt maintains our blood pressure, transmits nerve impulses, etc. Whereas chloride is used to produce hydrochloric acid in our stomach. Hence, to obtain salt, we have gradually developed a taste for it. Thus, salt in food makes it appealing and tasty. In addition to this, it is found that salt suppresses bitterness better than sugar. Researchers aren't sure how. Some researchers suggest that salt neutralizes the bitter tongue receptors, while some suggest that on adding salt, the brain interprets the taste as less bitter. Is fermented food good for us?
No! French fries are the best for me.
Alright, now listen. Fermentation is a process in which natural bacteria and yeast break down the sugar and starch present in the food, producing lactic acid and other compounds. For decades, fermenting was a technique to preserve food. However, nowadays, fermented food is getting a lot of attention because of the benefits it provides. Firstly, as the fermented food is pre-digested or broken down by bacteria, these foods are easier for us to digest. Secondly, fermentation increases the nutritional value by producing beneficial enzymes and vitamins.
Thirdly, as microorganisms break down lactose present in the food, lactose intolerant people can eat yogurt and other fermented milk products. Lastly, fermented foods contain probiotics, which are good or friendly bacteria. They improve our gut health, thus leading to a healthy immune system. Is expired food safe to eat?
No problemo. I'm as strong as Hulk.
Oh, AumSum. Usually we see three types of dates on food products. Sell by, best by, and use by. Use by is what we call the expiry date. Consuming food past this date may prove to be harmful. Firstly, the nutritional value of the food will reduce. Secondly, as bacteria don't usually grow at low temperatures, many foods are frozen. But if foods are kept at room temperature, bacteria will develop in them. Now, if consumed, they can cause vomiting, diarrhea, food poisoning, etc. Thirdly, it is believed that when canned food expires, the acids present in food react with the metal can and produce hydrogen gas, creating bulges in the can and thus making the food unsafe to eat. So, expiry date is definitely a good indicator. But apart from that, we should also rely on our senses of smell and sight to check the quality of the food. Are canned foods safe?
No, just pizzas are safe.
Oh, some. Canning is basically a method in which food items are processed and then packed in airtight containers. This helps preserve food for longer periods. However, there are some disadvantages of canned foods. Firstly, canned foods can be high in sugar and salt, so they can pose a risk for people with high blood pressure, diabetes, obesity, etc. Secondly, most cans have a coating of bisphenol A to prevent corrosion. Studies suggest that bisphenol A can leak into the food and have negative effects on our hormones and reproductive system. Thirdly, the acids present in food can react with the metal can and produce hydrogen gas, creating bulges, thus making food unsafe to eat. Lastly, improper canning process can lead to growth of dangerous bacteria called Clostridium botulinum. It produces a lethal toxin which, if consumed, can paralyze our muscles and cause death if left untreated. What if we only eat spicy food?
Nothing will happen. I eat lollipops every day.
Oh, Eating moderate amount of spicy food does have some advantages. Firstly, spices definitely increase the flavor of the food we eat. Secondly, some experts believe that capsaicin found in spicy foods helps in weight management by curbing our appetite and speeding up our metabolism. A study also found people to be more satiated after eating spicy food. Thirdly, capsaicin has anti-inflammatory and antimicrobial effects, which are good for our body. Disadvantages of eating too much spicy food are, firstly, they can decrease the sensitivity of our taste buds. Secondly, they can cause acid reflux. That is, acids and spices mix with stomach acid and irritate our food pipe lining. Thirdly, they can cause irritation of our gut, leading to diarrhea. Lastly, they can further worsen heartburn, stomach ulcers, and condition of people suffering from irritable bowel syndrome. Is overcooked food good for us?
Obviously. Burnt toast is my favorite.
Oh, AumSum. Overcooking or charring the food from outside is in trend because it adds a smoky flavor and enhances the taste. However, experts believe that overcooking can have negative health effects. Firstly, the longer you cook, the more nutrient loss occurs. Secondly, overcooked food is hard to digest and metabolize. Thirdly, when we cook starchy food at high temperatures for longer periods, the naturally occurring sugar and amino acids react to form harmful carcinogens like acrylamides. Whereas, overcooking of meat causes sugar, amino acids, and a substance called creatine to react, producing carcinogens called heterocyclic amines. Lastly, while grilling, fat from the meat can drip onto the burning coal, leading to the production of carcinogens called polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons. Hence, it is recommended to cook food just until it gets a golden yellow color and not until it turns brown or black.